Last week, we looked at Canva's new video 2.0 timeline, and I'll link to that video at the end of this one if you want to give it a watch. Now, motion in video can be so effective because it stops the scroll, it creates some interest and intrigue, and it makes even a few simple images feel really dynamic. Today, we're going to skip the full video editor and we're going to make super smooth motion just using pages, simple frames, and transitions. We're going to work step by step to build an animated image cascade that looks really slick, exports as a ready-to-post video, and you can reuse it for product shots, portfolios, or even weekly photo dumps. And we're going to do it all just using Canva. So let's start with an Instagram post design in Canva, mainly because it's versatile, it works across Instagram and other platforms, and it gives us a nice kind of square-ish canvas to design on. So next I'm going to drag out two guides, one at the top, one at the bottom, and I'm going to place them where they snap to the built-in guide that appears when you drag an element near them. This gives us our working area, and it helps to keep everything aligned and consistent throughout the animation. Next, we're just going to add a background color or texture or image, whatever fits with your brand. Just keep it simple though, because the images are going to be the stars here. I'm going to search for a grainy background, and I'm just going to use this one that kind of matches my brand colors. I'm going to drop that onto the page, adjust the sizing, and then right click and choose Replace Background. And then I'm going to actually make it 50% transparent, so it's even more subtle. Now, if you're creating this for a specific brand or a project, you could use the top and bottom space on the page to add a really subtle heading, or maybe your handle or website address. I'd position it outside of the guides where it won't interfere with the images. And once you're happy with it, I would then lock those text elements. Locking them just means that you won't accidentally move them while you're working with the rest of the design and frames. It's not a necessary step, but it really can save a lot of frustration later on. Okay, now we get to the fun part. Add a simple square frame to your canvas. You can find frames under the Elements menu, look for the Frame section, and then just click the square one. Frames just act as a placeholder for us to click and drag images in, helping to keep everything contained and easy to work with. Now copy and paste that frame until you have 5 total on your page, and then just move them so that you can see them all. And then we're going to click and drag our images in. We want to do that now because it can impact the animation that we're going to create. I'm actually just going to use a few from Canva's image library that I've previously used, but you can obviously upload your own or drag them from any of your folders. Next, we want to make them all the same size, quite big on the page, and center them all. You can select all the frames and use your position and arrange tool to center them to each other. And then I use Canva's automatic snap guides when I click and drag, just to help me center them to the page vertically and horizontally. Once you've got all 5 frames centered, we're going to duplicate the page. Now on the second page, we're going to reduce the size of all the image frames, and we're going to spread them out horizontally on a diagonal from top left to bottom right. And here's a little tip. Instead of eyeballing the spacing, you can just place your top left image where you want it and your bottom right image where you want it, then select all of those frames and go to Position Arrange and use the Distribute Horizontally and Vertically options. And it'll space everything perfectly without you having to fiddle with it manually. Next, we're going to duplicate page 2. And this is where things start to get really fun. On this page, page 3, we're going to reduce the top image in size and move it to the top left corner edge of your working space. They've already seen this image in a larger size because it was at the top of that stack, so we're just going to make it small now. Then take the second image and enlarge it. This is going to be your hero image on this page, the one that takes center stage. Position it so that the top left corner of the larger image aligns with the bottom right corner of the smaller first image. That creates a nice visual flow between the two. Now, to make this whole process easier, make a note of both sizes of the big and small image. When you click on the corner of a frame and you move your mouse slightly, the size label pops up so you can make a note. You can also go to Position, Arrange, and look at the Advanced section to check or to add dimensions manually. Next, take images 3, 4, and 5, and reduce them to the same size as the first small image. but move them to the bottom right of the working area. Make sure that the top left corner of small image 3 aligns with the bottom right corner of big image 2. And then spread those three small images out evenly in the bottom right. Again, you can use position, arrange, to distribute them perfectly. Now, aligning the corners and keeping spacing even just kind of keeps the visual connection flowing across the whole design. And the human eye picks up on discrepancies. Now, here's where the magic and the motion happens. You're going to repeat this exact process for each page with a new image. Duplicate the page, resize the images so that essentially they move one by one from small in the bottom right to large center stage, and then small in the top left as the next image takes center stage. Keep aligning them and keep the sizes consistent. And once you've done that for each image, you have a series of pages that make up your sequence, set up and ready to add some motion. But before we do that, if you enjoy these Canva tutorials and you want some more inspiration, insight, and design tips delivered straight to your inbox every week, I would love to invite you to join my newsletter. It's called Meaningful Creations. It goes out every week, and it's where I share a lot about design and building a business you love that I don't really share anywhere else. No fluff, no spam, just useful stuff to help you grow creatively in a really human way. You can just head to the link on the screen right now or in the description below the video to sign up. Okay, so let's get things moving, literally. First, select all your pages and reduce the page timing to around 1.5 seconds each. You can adjust this later depending on how fast or slow you want the animation to feel, but 1.5 seconds is a good starting point. If you don't see the option to adjust the timing for a page, just add a transition between any of the pages and you'll see it adds a timing option to that contextual toolbar at the top. Next, click the transition icon between the first two pages and choose Match and Move, our old favorite. And then be sure to click Apply to All. This is what makes the whole thing work so smoothly. Match and Move automatically animates the movement and resizing of your images between the pages. So it doesn't just cut from one to the next, it really flows. We obviously don't have the video timeline here anymore because this is a post design we started with, but you can just hit Preview at the top right and then play through the animation a few times so that you can check your timings. You can of course adjust the duration on the Match and Move transition and also on the individual page timing until it feels right for you and what you're trying to convey. Then because this is a pretty short sequence, I like to select all the pages from page one, duplicate them, and move them to the end so that it essentially creates another full playthrough of the animation for us to export as part of that MP4 video. Now at this point, you could add some music or sound effects, which would really take it to a whole new level, or you could just export it without, and you could choose some music inside your social app, so that way you can make use of maybe some trending audio, which always helps to get your post a little bit more visibility. So here is my finished cascade animation with a little bit of a smooth groove over it for a bit of style. And then we have a beautifully animated image cascade created entirely in Canva with just a few really simple pages. And as I mentioned, the beauty of this approach is that once you've created this, you can duplicate the whole project and just swap in elements and new images for a whole different vibe anytime that you want to use it. It's super simple, it's repeatable, and it's really effective. So if you found this helpful, please make sure to hit subscribe to this channel because according to YouTube, half the people who watch my videos are not subscribers. And I would really appreciate your support in growing the channel so that I can create more content like this for you. That's it, folks. Have a fabulous week. Please look after yourself and I'll see you next one.